You may have heard that 60% of engineering students drop out or change majors, and that 40% do so within the first year. Now, these numbers that I got from a sketchy LinkedIn article may or may not be accurate, but the fact is, a lot more people start engineering school than finish it, and the highest drop-off rate is in the first year. So today I want to talk about why I think that is, and what you can do to prevent this from happening to you. Hey and welcome back to my channel. My name is Anna and I'm a German mechanical engineer based in Sweden. So I know a thing or two about studying since I've studied at university 7 years of my life. At least I got a couple of degrees out of it. So using that experience, let me talk you through 5 reasons why I think people drop out of engineering school and what you can do about it. So the first reason why I think a lot of people drop out of engineering school is that they have the wrong expectations about what engineering is. And I see 2 main wrong reasons why people go into engineering with the wrong expectations. So the first wrong reason to go into engineering is because they like building stuff. So I know a lot of people who went into it thinking that there's going to be a lot of hands-on work, like building an engine and doing experiments, tuning cars. As an engineer, you can certainly benefit from having a lot of hands-on experience. The more you have of that, the better. And there are many engineering jobs where you do very hands-on work. And even there's some projects in engineering school, but it's just not the focus of university. And especially not in the first year. So you're gonna have to be fine with spending a lot of time in front of your computer and with sticking through all of the theoretical math and physics classes throughout the first year before you get to do some of the more applied stuff. And the second wrong reason I see people go into engineering is as an easy or guaranteed way to make a lot of money. And there are just so many way easier ways to make money than engineering. Like go to finance or sales or business administration, literally anything. Engineering is really not worth it if money is the only motivator because it just requires too much very difficult work. And what can you do to make sure that you have the right expectations about engineering? So first thing I would say, watch as many YouTube videos as you can about engineering and go look up all of the different types of engineering and understand what they're about to kind of get this really holistic picture of engineering and what kind of different branches there are and also what the jobs are going to look like. Even though I know it's really, really difficult to find this kind of information, and I'm trying to my best to make videos about it. And there are some other great YouTubers making videos about this as well. But just, even though it's difficult to find, really do your best to find information on what you're gonna be studying. So also you can go on the university website and look through the list of courses, then look into also what is the job going to look like. And actually one thing you can do to really get a good understanding is try to find other students that are already doing that program that you wanna do on LinkedIn and then message them and see if they're willing to hop on a short call with you. I have been on the other side of that, so I know that people are willing to go on a call. So yeah, just give it a try. The second reason why I see people drop out is that the first year sucks way more than the rest. Obviously, this depends a lot on the university, but typically engineering programs start with all of the basics. So you get your math courses, your mechanics courses, maybe some basics of electrical engineering. And what all of this has in common is that you don't have any clue what you could possibly need that for in the future. It's just the pure math and physics, and that can be really, really demotivating. Well, the first thing is you can mentally prepare. Now you know what to expect. You know that the first year is probably going to suck and that it hopefully is only going to get better after that. And the other thing you can do is pick up the slack of your professors and build your own motivation. Look up what the hell you're actually going to need that math or that physics for and think about how great of an engineer you're going to be and how cool the projects will be that you can do with that once you've mastered the basics. The third reason I see people drop out is because they treat it like high school. There are certain strategies that might be successful in high school to pass classes or even to get good grades. Strategies like studying the night before or just paying good attention in class and hoping you remember everything, not even taking notes unless the teacher tells you to, remembering all of your homework and classes in your head without a calendar or anything, and packing your schedule full of activities. This ain't gonna fly in university. So the workload is much higher, the material is much more difficult, and there are a lot of different deadlines to keep track of. And so if you start out with the same strategies as in high school, you're going to fall on your nose. Now, this is completely normal. Don't beat yourself up about it. It happens to pretty much everyone when they start out. The big question is how you react to that. Because especially if you are a really good student in high school, you probably don't have a very high frustration tolerance. Meaning that if you're not instantly good at something, you will feel really bad about it. That was definitely the case for me. And you need to look at that and say, yep, that didn't work. Let me figure out why this didn't work and what I can do better. You will figure out your own new strategies as you go, but here are just a couple of recommendations from me. When you're then choosing your courses and also deciding how much else you can do, like hobbies or a job or other activities, then for every class that you put into your schedule, I want you to add at least double the class time as studying time and block that out in your week. So if your class is 2 times per week and it's 2 hours each, then I want you to block out at least 8 hours of homework and studying time. This might seem a little bit excessive, but it's really better to start high and then realize over time, okay, maybe for this kind of class I need more, for this one I need a little bit less time. But the biggest mistake I see is packing your schedule too full and then not being able to manage all of it and feeling like you're failing. It is just a case that you need to spend a lot of time studying and you need to plan for that. Second recommendation is to get yourself a calendar, ideally a digital one, and then put in all of your classes, all of your deadlines, exams, studying time, office hours of your professors, and of course also all of your hobbies, your job, and other appointments. And just make sure to check it every day, then you should be fine. Then I also want you to decide on a central place to put all of your to-dos. I recommend a digital place like Trello, but a notebook also works, as long as it is all in one place. And finally, whenever you don't understand something, don't go, "It's fine, I'll understand this eventually." You need to do everything in your power to understand it as soon as possible. So first of all, write down exactly what it is that you don't understand. Try to really get to the core of it, and then try to Google it and YouTube it, ask your classmates, go to your professor's office hours, whatever you can to understand it. Because the longer that you go without understanding one thing, the more things are probably gonna be piled on top of that, that build on this one thing you didn't understand. And then you're just gonna have a big mess of things you don't understand, and that's just not good. The fourth reason that I see people struggling and dropping out of engineering school is that they put more pressure on themselves than necessary. So what is necessary? If your goal is to become an engineer, then you need to complete your engineering degree. And for that, you need to pass all of the required classes. Everything else is not necessary. It's optional. So personally, I have never heard of an engineer who couldn't find a job because they didn't do enough extracurricular activities and because their grades weren't good enough. Of course, it's great if you can get excellent grades in every single class and work 2 jobs, do an internship every summer, and volunteer and do your own engineering projects on the side. But if you're feeling like you're failing because you're not doing all of these things, then ask yourself, what is my goal and what is really necessary? Now, I know that a lot of engineering students need to work on the side for financial reasons, but if you can, I would recommend to at least not work within the first year of engineering, because this is really where you get used to studying and build up your strategies. And then once you have developed some good strategies for studying and managing your time, then you can add on top of that. Or if you can avoid it, then get yourself a job that's as easy as possible. Something where you just have to show up and then you go home without taking any work home with you. This is really important for the beginning, because any other things where you also have to kind of organize your own time are just going to add on top of that. And then over time, it's absolutely fine to do things on top of your studies if you feel ready for it. You will get much better at organizing yourself and at studying efficiently. And eventually you might even have the capacity to work in an engineering company a few hours a week, or to do your own project on the side, or to volunteer somewhere. But if you feel pressure to do all of these things from the start because you see other people do it, and somehow you see, you know, this one person doing a job, this other person volunteering, and this other person building a side project on the side, and you're like, oh my god, I have to do all of these things, then stop that right now. You have a lot of time, and even if you just did the bare minimum, which is passing your degree, passing your classes, then you can still become an engineer. And the fifth reason I see people dropping out of engineering school is that they figure out it's really just not for them, but maybe something else is. Sometimes there's just nothing you can do. You did your research before, you thought you knew exactly what you were getting yourself into, but maybe already in the first few months or after 1 or 2 years, you realize that you are in the wrong major. I actually have a lot of former classmates who this happened to. So they all started studying mechanical engineering with me, and most of them were even doing okay, but then they found something else that they thought was really cool that they wanted to do instead. For example, one of my friends switched to architecture, one switched to biotechnology, and one to business administration. And even if the statistics make it look like this, that is not a failure. That is actually fantastic. Sometimes your first major is just your best guess, because it's also confusing and difficult to see what it's actually going to be like. And sometimes you change also while you're studying and you're growing. So even if your major doesn't end up being for you, it still has has a much higher chance of helping you figure out what you actually want to do instead than sitting at home and doing nothing will. Because it will get you in contact with lots of other students from other majors, and there's a lot of different subjects you're going to learn even within your major, but also you are able often to take free elective classes where you get to dive into a different subject that maybe ends up being the one subject you really want to do a lot more with. Or maybe you make a friend who's doing a different major that you find interesting and they can take you to some of the classes, so you can just check it out. Now, I know in some countries there's a lot more money involved in university than in Germany or Sweden, but just from a career perspective, there really is no downside to switching your major if this means that you end up with a thing that you really want to do. So please don't force yourself to stick with it just for the sake of sticking with it. But again, please remind yourself that the first year is probably gonna suck way more than the rest of the studies. So don't take it as representative and make a really informed decision about whether or not the right thing is for you to drop out or to stick with it. One really good question you can ask yourself is, are you quitting because you found this other thing that you're really excited to do that you are quitting towards? Or is it just really hard right now? You want to quit away from your major, but it's not really something that you're going towards. I think the first option is a way better situation to be in than the second one, where you might just want to stick it out until you found something else that you actually want to do. Now, if you are struggling with getting through engineering school or with picking the right major or even with finding a job afterwards and you would like some more personal support, I do offer mentoring for engineering students and recent graduates. And if you're interested, you can read more about that in the description box down below. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it and I hope to see you in my next video.